say, what do you think about dreams?
I think they're truthful.
They're truthful.
Mm-hmm.
About what?
About states of mind.
Mm. Makes them rather important.
Yeah. Mm. But they're mysterious, they're symbolic or something. So they're hard to... Like, I had a dream last night that was creepy. So, anyway.
Yeah. 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 Remember that creepy feeling?
Yeah.
Dream? Yeah. Was it like what I when we were I was talking with you last time?
Yeah.
Is that interesting? You picked up that feeling state you had?
Yeah.
Does that bring tears to your eyes?
Yeah. It's like hard work, and I don't want to do it.
No. Notice.
Yeah.
You judge it in terms of work.
True. Mm-hmm.
When you do that, what does that do?
Okay, thank you.
Oh, thanks. What does it do in terms of hard work?
It touches a mirror, doesn't it?
Yeah, because I think ultimately I won't be able to do it, persevere. Hey.
How is it?
Good.
I see.
Oh.
You brought a couple long colleagues with you.
And one was parking.
Are you Juan?
Pleasure.
Hello.
Oh.
Hello.
Good to see you.
Hi, Regina.
Oh, hi. Hi. He said hello. It's good.
Hi, Mark.
Hi.
How
are you guys? I think I'll be basically...
Sorry.
Drowning. It's like a sense of I'll be overcome and drowning.
Yeah.
And it'll be a slow kind of painful.
Yeah.
But at the same time in the dream I was aware that it was a therapist.
What?
A therapist. It was a therapy.
What does that mean?
Well, I was being overseen by some people who knew what they were doing in the field of the body and the mind and kind of medicine. And the task was very simple.
Of course.
It was like childish.
Yes, but it gave the image and carried the image of work, didn't it?
Yeah, because I had to use my body.
Yeah. What? Say it again.
I had to use my body.
And that meant work, certain kind of work.
Yeah. And a certain kind of fear.
And a certain kind of fear.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah.
But it was child's play.
Of course. It has to be.
Interesting. Interesting.
Why don't you ask me why?
Why? Why does it have to be child's play?
Your mind is telling you your idea of work needs to be examined.
Yeah.
Because the kind of work that you're considering is very simple and doesn't have to fit under the label of your idea of work.
Yeah, even in the dream, it was like, I can't tell them that this is work because it's obviously not.
But it has the impact personally to you of what work means.
Right.
That goes to the heart of your soul.
Gina, which of the two is
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like when I was young, I had a... It's like... In sports, I had a couple of... Like, I was really good at baseball, but I couldn't run fast. And I always wondered, why can't I run fast? Or in swimming, I was in synchronized swimming, and yet I couldn't do laps for a long time. And I was like, why can't I, why do I, it's like I, same fear, kind of. And yet if I know when I'm in the zone, I can do laps forever.
Yes.
But I freak out or something and think, I can't do this.
Yeah, that involves body, work, a task.
And breathing.
Right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Some kind of breathing.
We're going to be doing her dream, but she mentioned she had a dream last night, and I pointed out to her it's likely to have its origin in what happened to her last night. So we've been talking about the impact of what happened to her last night in terms of her dream.
Cool.
Yeah.
Does either of you want to be in the shade?
So behind it, there's likely to be a little state of mind that goes back to some nice early scene that ties those words together, right?
Right.
Being told to do something. Take on a task.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe simple, but it doesn't look like you want to do it.
Yeah, it's like fighting it rather than just giving into it and relaxing into it. I want to fight it.
Yeah, no, must fight it.
Why must fight it? Or apparently.
Oh. Must fight it.
Okay. Well, why do you say must fight it?
We'll see.
Okay.
Ready?
I know it went against an image I had of my parents. They seemed like unable to, they could barely move.
That's right.
And it's like,
hey.
Mm-hmm.
Then each of those things, you're doing something that they, in principle, finish with.
In principle, they couldn't attain.
Yeah.
Or wouldn't let themselves, or, it was actually, you know, they had a whole litany of things you weren't supposed to be as a woman. You weren't supposed to be beautiful or rich, as a human being. Don't be beautiful, don't stand out in any way. And also part of that list should have been, and it was unspoken, don't be too feisty or don't be too...
But
well,
you got it.
Funny. Lively is the word. And you know, my neighbors found a cat, and they're Spanish, they're in Mexico. They named it Treviosa. And I said, what's Treviosa mean? They said trouble. So I'm thinking, oh, you're naming your cat trouble. Well, when I looked up Treviosa, it actually means lively and spontaneous, right? But for the kid in the household, that meant trouble. So.
Did you ever tell them that?
I did.
What did they do?
Well, he just said, okay. So
no. What do you mean? Okay.
Well, I don't know if it sunk in. I'm gonna have to ask him again. But that's the same kind of thing in my family. Like you could sit around and watch TV. You could sit around and eat ice cream. You could sit around and get drunk and pass out. But don't be too lively. Don't be up and about and playing and moving and.
And that's what you were.
Yeah, that's what I was.
And therefore, when you went into it, they carried their teaching and knew what? You were violating it.
I was violating it, right.
Whole way of being.
As soon as I'd start to run around the bay, I could pitch, I could hit, I could be the best pitcher, the best hitter. But when it came to running and moving.
Moving.
I was like, it was like, God, what's going on here?
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or when it came to like.
Or unless you got in the zone, as you call it.
Yeah.
Yeah, then when you're out of it.
Then I'm just like taken over and something else is moving me.
Then then it's not you.
Right.
Something else is moving you.
Right.
It couldn't be you because you're the one that's not allowed to move.
Right.
Yeah, and you know, the whole problem is whether or not you're right about that, whether it's the opposite. That's you and the other is on.
Right. Yeah.
What? What do you think of that?
I think that's true.
If it's true, what are you going to do about it?
Wait. I don't know. That's a new one. I'm new here.
We're back to the old question, huh? What is yourself? Which one?
Yeah.
Right? Which one do you think it is?
Yeah, I thought there was something wrong with me.
No.
No.
Not something wrong with you until you figure out what the you is.
Yeah. True.
State the problem or the way you see it right now about the talk we had.
And my dream last night?
That was just the talk we had. What do you think? How it might apply?
Well, you know, I've thought of like taking my students through a guided meditation in my classroom.
What is that like?
It's absolutely terrifying. I won't do it.
See, you won't be a teacher.
Right.
Does that mean you have to move? Have to act.
Yeah.
Yeah. Say, just between you and me, can you share something?
Hope so.
How are you doing your meditations? What can you teach if you were allow yourself to teach?
I could teach the breathing.
We both know that's not sufficient. What kind of breathing? Where will it go? Can you tell me?
Well, they could count their breaths and see that their mind is not in control. I could do that.
Hey.
To bring them back.
You're not willing to answer.
Well, I can't teach anything substantive.
Why not? That's what we're talking about. Say, try one more thing before we go in your dream.
Yeah.
Say, if you could get into that zone, could you then teach what you know?
I know.
That's pretty good, you know. That's pretty good.
I mean, I remember being taught breathing and it was really helpful. And I still rely on that.
Yeah.
taking the students through, like, questions. I don't want to do that. It's embarrassing.
You see, you're taking this discussion on the lowest level.
Okay.
Yes, you're right? Shall we agree?
Mm-hmm.
On the highest level,
yeah.
Where could you take students if you decided to do it? If. Say, hey.
Yeah.
Julie?
Like,
hey, you know those ox herding pictures?
Yeah.
Talk about where you, what you could do if you were to teach.
Well, you know, I haven't really studied those.
Bullshit.
I mean, I'm aware
hey,
of them,
bullshit.
But
come on, stop this. Come on. You don't have to study them.
Well, I could have them.
Right? Hey, come on.
Compare themselves to the ox herding pictures.
Yeah. From your experience
mm-hmm.
in this game of meditation.
Yeah.
Ideally, from which one could you teach if you were to teach?
From which one?
Yeah, from which one? Second, third?
The answer?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay, that's good. Which won't go anywhere?
Okay.
Yeah. By the way, is there such a thing as clear light?
Clear light?
No, is there that divine luminosity stuff?
Sure.
Oh. Ever get in it? When you sit?
Yeah.
Louder?
Yeah.
Louder? Louder, please. I didn't hear you.
I don't.
Louder?
No, I don't get into it much.
I don't get into it much.
I mean, I have.
Sorry.
I have. Can you get into it?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I guess I could because I have, but I don't get into it.
But you could.
Yeah.
If you could teach what you know,
uh-huh.
you would be teaching that then, is that right?
I guess. I didn't think of it that way.
But it would be a lot of work.
Probably. Not work, since the mind is just goes there.
Yeah.
The mind is
that goes beyond work.
Something other than work.
Oh, so you could do it. Is that right?
Probably I could do it.
Hmm?
Probably I could do it. It's really about it.
Do you remember telling me that you went into a certain state that when you sat down you just went into a very high state?
No.
Anytime you did. You don't recall that. I had a feeling you didn't recall that because you weren't able to reference it, but you said to me that it was effortless for you when you meditated. You could just kind of sit down to meditate and you went right into a very magnificent I'm using the word magnificent meaning very high in the hierarchy of enlightenment experiences or high states of mind, and you just kind of said that was what happened whenever you sat down to meditate. A natural oncoming of that state. So
what you said?
I don't know. I mean, I get into a state, I don't think of it as all that.
What is it then?
I don't know. It's just an empty state.
Empty state. Which is, can you put any more words on that?
Boring.
No, it's not boring. It's nice.
When you said right, what do you mean?
It's nice. I said it's nice. It's just it's a nice state. It's exciting. It's adventurous. And, I don't know, it's fun. I'm looking forward to it.
Does it fit with that other word you were using earlier?
What word?
The terrible state.
Terrible state? No.
I meant, you said that, well, it was a joke. Sorry.
I wouldn't call it lively.
The lively state that you talked about.
Oh, yes, lively. Uh-huh. But I wouldn't call it clear light.
What would you call it?
I wouldn't call it anything.
Well, then you don't have to worry.
Yeah.
Is it worth being in?
Yeah.
Oh, could you teach us?
Teach.
Could you help others get there?
Yeah. With some with some work, I guess.
See?
I mean, just helping them eliminate what's coming up.
Would be helpful. Uh-huh. So you could be a teacher.
Yeah.
Thank you. I just thought I'd ask.
Okay.
That, yeah. Well, before I got into your dreams, it's just a tangent, isn't it?
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Now that we've gotten rid of that.
Checked off that.
Checked that off. Yeah.
Say that September 3rd dream.
Uh huh.
Yeah. You end with a statement. So it was just fun.
Yeah.
Describe it.
You know, it was kind of that spontaneous state. I mean, we were just, together, and there wasn't an agenda. It was like we were just, kind of doing what came to mind or something. It was like spontaneous.
Hey, is that like what you just talked about?
Yeah.
Ah. What do you know about that? Is that an accident?
Yeah, we're just hanging out and making it better. And
yeah. And in what state of mind then?
Comfortable.
Yeah.
Making it more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. By the way, you're doing things in the dream. You're in motion.
Right.
Even though it's simple, you're acting, are you not?
Yeah.
You're going against the family teaching in this dream, aren't you?
Yeah.
Right? Making decisions.
And there was a lot of space. There was a lot of open. Like right now where I live is so cramped. I can't even barely move. So this was big dining room, and it went into a big, it was a nice wooden floor. And
yeah, but so tell me, what did it do to you to be there in the dream?
It gave me the freedom to,
freedom.
I think,
right? Come on.
Consider anything.
And that's similar to the state you were describing a short while ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. Right. Anything, yeah.
That interesting that this dream mirrors the state of mind you were talking about.
Yeah, it is.
And the dynamics of it as well. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah.
Hmm.
So you're living, hey, in the dream world. Would you say you're re-experiencing your states of meditation? The higher states?
Yeah.
Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
And the work was kind of simple.
Yeah.
Easy, natural, flowing,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Yeah, pretty interesting, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Understand you have another dream.
Yeah, this one of two.
Yeah, let's do the second. What do you see? Why don't you tell me?
Well, I find it curious that this last paragraph, the last, so.
Yeah.
I think I had had this. See, I had thought about letting a teacher at Fullerton College know about our workshop coming up because he's interested in the logos in the Greeks. And so I said here, when Alex, someone like Alex,
yeah.
In the dream, I couldn't remember that teacher's name. I wanted to think of the teacher's name. Instead, I said, someone like Alex.
Yeah.
Because I was thinking, what if he comes to our workshop? Will he be able to feel comfortable enough to ask a question? Or if he does ask a question, will he feel, like, uncomfortable? So I think this dream might be in reference to my concern about that guy coming to the workshop. But, okay.
That's not the issue for you.
Right.
Last sentence.
Right. Like,
well,
in fact,
it was like, go ahead.
It was like I was being very subversive.
Agreed.
Okay. The last paragraph?
Same paragraph you were in, yeah.
And I felt like I was being very subversive. In fact, when I did it, when I put the pot, the plant on the ground, on the garden soil.
No. You were talking about the paragraph with Alex, weren't you?
Oh, up here.
Yeah. Third one, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, and there's the thought that maybe somebody I know might want to say, someone like Alex, what if he has a question about these ideas and he wants to raise a question, how would he do it? And again, it's like the fixed format wouldn't allow a question about the same plant.
Stop. What's the issue?
The issue is introducing a new angle to talk about. I don't know, it's weird, I don't get the same plant business. But the issue is introducing a new angle to talk about some ideas.
Can't read the sentence again, it is clear.
Oh. And again, it's like the fixed format wouldn't allow a question about the same plant.
Thank you. What's the issue?
The issue is that the format to ask a question about this plant is fixed and won't allow.
Thank you.
Any other.
Then what's the issue then?
The restricted format about the plant.
Go ahead, say it again. You got it.
The restricted format about the plant.
Yeah, that puzzles you, doesn't it? Right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
About the same plant.
Yeah. That could bring tears to your eyes.
Not really.
Yeah. What?
Not really.
Oh.
But I feel like it's
what?
Something unfair or...
Yeah, unfair.
Real serious.
Yeah.
That... But at the same time, it doesn't make sense.
That part, forget that part.
Okay.
It has its own sense.
Okay, what if he has a question about these ideas and wants to raise a question? How would he do it? And again, it's like a fixed format. It would allow a question about the same plan.
So what's the problem?
Yeah. And then I remember I said it's so interesting trying to talk about this because it's hard to. So the next paragraph.
I finished what you just said.
That it's, it was. I made the comment that it was difficult talking about these ideas.
Given the fixed format.
Yeah, there was like a fixed format.
Yeah.
To talk about the dream.
Yeah. Yeah. Do the same thing with the first sentence, the last sentence, and the first paragraph.
Okay. I mean, like, Gina's talking about these words, mathematical ideas, and it's like they're in a white container that's shaped a certain way, and I'm thinking that she's got a certain position about these ideas, and they conform to this pot, this white plastic pot that the plant is in. And it's like we're agreeing.
What's that? It's like we're agreeing.
Like, the ideas seem to be agreeing about the heart of the idea,
mm-hmm.
but the way in which she's doing it, I don't agree with, or I want to change or something.
Sure. Well, and there's something about it they don't like.
Right.
Yeah.
It's the way.
So, see, hold that. Then what does that do to the last sentence in that paragraph?
In that last paragraph?
That's the first paragraph.
Oh.
Last sentence in the first paragraph.
And it's like we're agreeing.
What is that like in the dream?
That she thinks we're agreeing, and everyone thinks we're agreeing, but in my mind, I know there's something more I want to say to be true to myself and what I'm seeing.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, and you're hiding that behind that phrase.
The phrase, it's like we're agreeing.
Yeah. Because now you're saying what it really means is...
Oh. That we don't agree,
yeah.
But I'm not speaking
yeah.
up.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, true.
Yeah. And that's why you bring up Alex in the dream, isn't it? Wonder what he would be like given this
right
restrictive finishing.
Well, I think he would also have a disagreement with how things are going. And he would have trouble. He would try to say something, but would have trouble.
It's like you.
Yeah.
In the dream. That's your state, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. The point is, this fellow is involved in the logos, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right? What does that mean?
That he would definitely have something to say.
Yeah.
Or us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Does that, in the dream, so you're reflecting on him, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And is he going to be aware that there's going to be a restriction on what's allowed? The questions are allowed?
I think he's going to feel it.
He may or may not voice it.
Right.
Yeah.
I think he'll be frustrated.
Yeah. He's an interesting guy, isn't he?
Yeah.
In your dream?
Yeah.
Yeah, talk about him. He's in the logos, is that right?
Yeah, he has a question and he wants to raise the question.
What state of mind is he in the dream as you pursue it?
He would be like me meditating. He'd be open and enthusiastic like and adventurous.
He's a teacher, right?
Yeah.
Like you, only you're not willing to be one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's interesting, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, therefore, in the fourth paragraph, Alex, go ahead.
So, again, so I'm thinking of something of putting the mathematical ideas here into a plastic pot and setting them somewhere so that when Alex arrived, he could have access to it and then he'd be able to talk.
Thank you. What role are you playing?
Facilitating.
Baloney.
Okay.
Facilitating. Jesus.
Thinking of something of putting here into sitting somewhere so that when Alex arrived, he can have access to it.
Come on.
I don't want to say teacher.
Why not?
Because I don't think...
It's a dream. How are you functioning? Come on.
I'm helping him to be able to talk, making it easier for him to have access. Yeah, it's a weird dream here.
Come on. Stay in the words. You're cheating.
He'd have access to the ideas... He'd be able to talk.
Then he'll be able to talk. What are you doing to him?
It's that fixed format. I guess I'm changing the format so that...
Oh!
It's not so fixed.
Oh, what role are you playing? With Alex?
Formatter.
Oh, no. Ow! Take a look. The guy is... The image you have of the guy is... similar to in the similar state of mind as in one of your meditations that is so profound, right?
Okay.
And are you helping him?
Yeah.
What kind of a person do you think you must be if you can help someone with that background and that position and that status?
I don't want to say. I don't think that's teaching. I don't know. I should.
Bricklayer.
Animal trainer? I don't know. I guess that's a teacher.
Oh, what?
Teacher?
No kidding. How is the mind... Come on, what role do you have in the dream? Come on, finish it. Come on, tell me.
Helping him gain access to something that he'd be able to talk about.
You're freeing the logos. Is that right? He's the logos, and you're freeing his ability to express the logos, what he represents.
Right. I thought that was a therapist.
A therapist?
That ain't a therapist, honey.
That's why I always wanted to be a therapist.
No, you didn't. That's a lot of baloney. You'd like to function like you're functioning in the dream. Is that right? Tell me, what is it like at that moment?
This is just how I function.
Tell me how you were functioning at that time.
Okay, I was still making it. I had forethought. I could judge what he needed.
Right.
The ideas and to be able to talk.
And you could bring about the change in him.
And I could bring it about, set up the situation.
Yeah, is that a therapist? You know any therapist that could do that? Hey, use the word teacher. What kind of a teacher are you in my training? Are you working with new people or brand new? Don't understand.
You know, I think of this as like a grade school teacher, you know, that when they have to move stuff around and get ready for the new kids, and it's like grade school.
Yeah, wait a minute. No.
I don't think of this
wait
as
a
college.
Minute. Bullshit. The state of mind you just described is quite correct. The fact that you assigned it to the first grade, I can ignore.
Grade school.
Therefore, what state of mind are you in? As if you're in the first grade helping kids doing what? What state of mind would you be in?
Playful.
Yeah, see?
So that when they arrive, so when Alex arrives, he can have access to her.
Yeah.
And then be able to talk.
Yeah.
So nice one, dude.
Yeah.
It's like you had to have that particular thought in your hand in order to be asking questions about it or talking about it. So you'd have access to it.
Right, yeah. You have to be able to grab on that restriction.
Right. Very interesting.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now deal with the last paragraph, the last sentence.
But really, I always thought this is how a grade school teacher functioned.
Ideally, any teacher, baloney.
Okay. Okay. And then the last. Okay, and when I did that, act like a teacher.
Yeah.
It was like we were in an area, like the landing of my rich kid's driveway.
Yeah.
And we would come to it, to her house.
Yeah.
We'd come up the hill and then stop on the landing there. And I felt like I was being very subversive.
Yeah.
Shoot. In fact, when I did it, when I put the plant on the ground, on the garden soil, in that area, that raised bed area, I remember walking around, looking at the vehicle, seeing where I had made the dent, seeing if I had dented something, to see if I was going to be found out, to see if I'd be charged with
right.
an accident.
Right, right, right.
Oh, my God.
That's
how terrible.
That's the family, isn't it?
Wow, for being a teacher.
Yeah.
Suddenly I'm guilty.
Thank you.
Oh, wait a second. Shoot. Thank you. Oh, my God.
Good job.
Woo! shoot. What a trip. Dang. Wow. Yeah.
I won't tell anybody.
That's a good one.
Hey, I won't tell anyone that you're really a teacher in hiding.
In hiding.
Yeah.
Boy.
And you might even have fun if you were to do it.
Right. Yeah, I remember when I was young, when I was about third grade, I remember I was dusting in the living room, and my mother's in the kitchen, and I think she said something like, so what do you want to do when you grow up or something? I said, I don't want to be a teacher. Because I was thinking teachers were like third and fourth grade people. And I just knew for sure I didn't want to do that. And yet this was kind of what this...
You haven't finished the story.
Well, all of her her aunts were teachers. In the small town where they lived, there were the Anderson girls, and they were all teachers. And that was...
And they were all like
mothers.
What?
Probably like Methodist.
That doesn't tell me what they're like.
You know, I have no idea.
You do so. Stop the bullshit.
Well, straight-laced and...
Thank you. Now, come on now.
Okay,
yeah, yeah.
That kind of stuff, yeah.
Come on.
Right.
So it isn't that they're just Methodists. They're what? Straight leg. Come on.
Rigid.
So is it that you didn't want to be a teacher, or you didn't want to be like the Andersons?
Yeah, I didn't want to be
like
them.
That was
my idea of what...
Yeah.
Right.
Curious, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel a little guilty about it all.
Well, you will, as long as you're doing something good.
Yeah. Gee, thanks.
Okay. Fun.
Yeah. Good. Thanks.
Those teachers, the rigid teachers, sound so contained.
Yes, they sound so contained.
Contained. The teachers sound very contained.
Yeah,
but you were
moving.
Afraid that you'd put a dent.
Right.
In something.
Something like that. My rich aunt, like in one of her cars or something.
Oh, God.
That were up on that landing.
Also, what kind of teacher are you? In the sense of. It looks like the opposite role to most teachers I've seen.
Well, I'm moving around here, rearranging
yeah.
stuff and
yeah.
having the forethought to see that it would help somebody's logos.
In order that they might...
Just help somebody's logos.
Yeah, that's all.
Just somebody. Who just represents the logos in the dream.
Apart from
that, he's just another guy.
Yeah, maybe teacher's not even good enough, right? Yeah, I might get into more meditation.
Okay.
Right. What are those things that bring about goods for others?
What are those things?
What does that?
Goods for others?
Comprehend the nature of a person, see what would be good for them, and provide a method for them to come to that
right.
goodness of participation of logos.
Yeah, some providence. Mm-hmm. A very providential function and with forethought. Promethean.
Also, Jules, you're not stuffing them with stuff.
Yeah, right.
So is that a different role than...
A fresh cup of coffee for a fresh dream.
Totally.
But rather, what would you say is it... What kind of teacher might it be close to? What subject matter? I just wanted to...
Well, the
and that's not really what I meant to say.
What did you want to say?
You're giving someone an ability, aren't you? Does
putting
that compare
ability,
to
ability? Yeah.
Well, is that an interesting kind of a teacher?
Free up the logos.
Yeah. Well, you use the word he'd be able to talk.
That's right.
Right. So, yeah. That's a specific kind of teaching. And I think it falls in a specific kind of class, like gymnastics.
Absolutely.
Right? Give someone an ability to do something. You teach someone and give them the ability to do something. You don't do it for them, right?
Right.
So anyway, that's why I was wondering what kind.
Well, I was putting the plastic pot in a place where he could pick it up, and then he'd have that ability.
Yes.
So it's kind of cool. It's kind of like a magical kind of.
Yes and no, but magical?
Like
magical
in
kind
those
of derived.
Harry Potter books, you know, where they grab, or like the ring, you know, you put on the ring and now you're able to do something.
Yeah, it's
enabling.
Yeah. I'm an enabler.
Or
you're rather different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Well, rather different than magic or different than enabling?
Disappear.
Both, I think.
Okay.
Providing the
Virginia?
Conditions for him to
you're
be
up.
Able to come out.
Yeah, so I have the forethought.
Good.
Okay.
Let Regina sit there.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Siéntese, señora.
You want to sit here.